Horizon Discovery has announced its research biotech business has formed a joint venture with Centauri Therapeutics, which will be known as Avinity. I have Horizon's chief executive, Darrin Disley, on the line to discuss the deal. Good morning, Darrin.
Good morning.
So, Darrin, this partnership is in immuno-oncology therapeutics, a market which you say is worth £25 billion, huge number. Can you tell us exactly what this encompasses?
Yeah, so immuno-oncology is a new class of therapeutics. We're effectively exploiting the ability of drugs, whether they be antibodies or small molecules, or in this case, a novel class of drugs called alphamers, that effectively redirect the immune system to recognize cancer as a foreign object. So just like when you get a bacterial infection, we effectively now be able to target cancer and the flags it puts up on its surface that effectively causes the cancer to proliferate. It identifies those, latches onto them, and then recruits the human body's natural immune system to target those cancer cells as though they were an infection. And then they're able to effectively digest those cancer cells and clear them from the body. So providing a very clear mechanism of action for targeting cancer.
And like I have mentioned, it's a huge market, but also a fast-growing one, isn't it?
Yes, you know, 25 billion, the first classes of therapeutics are now hitting the market, targeting these genes called PD-1 and CTLA-4. These are already multi-billion dollar revenue drugs, and this market is expected to double over the next 5 to 10 years with this new class of immunotherapies.
Let's talk a bit more about Avinity. What will you be trying to develop, and for what diseases?
Yep, so our target is cancer, and the beauty of this technology, we call it alphamer technology. It was actually invented by Nobel Prize winner Carrie Mullis, who won the Nobel Prize for one of the greatest inventions, I think, of the 20th century, the PCR. All of genomics research has been built off of that invention. And he has developed this class of drugs called alphamers, and what we're doing is targeting cancers of unmet need. So the typical antibody drugs, which are making up the most of the market right now, target cancers that are driven by mutant expression. So when you hear of mutations, they are targeting those mutations that lead to high expression, and they target those. What these alphamers are able to do is target both those, but also cancers that are driven by natural expression, which other types of drugs cannot target. So we're targeting a range of things that are either very difficult to drug this way, or they have other issues where, you know, antibody drugs can't target them. So we should yield development candidate drugs in around 18 months to 24 months, which can then be taken into the clinic, at which point there's a huge value inflection point, and we will raise funds from third parties to take those forward.
Okay, so it's for all type of hard-to-treat cancers?
Yes, the beauty of these immunotherapies is that you're able to target with either very high, what we call high expressing cancers, like melanoma is a real example, so skin cancer, for example. But these types of drugs can also target things that have relatively low natural expression, so cancers that are in blood cancers, colon cancers, various things like that. So yes, quite broad.
So it sounds like it's a very significant deal for the company, isn't it? A game-changing deal?
It is. It's part of our strategy. So, you know, there's three parts to our business. There is a products and services business, and we've reported on that recently. That business has been growing over 100% growth a year over the last 8 years, and we've reported this year 70% growth, well ahead of expectations. This second part of our business, we call it the research biotech, is about exposing our investors to some of this upside of the really high-end areas of therapeutic development, so immunotherapies, cell therapies, gene therapies, where you're actually looking at things like that, where you're correcting disease. And our model is to invest an amount of cash, and we announced to the market an initial £10 million of cash, and we leverage that alongside our IP technology and expertise in cancer and immunology, and we can get milestones, royalties, and in this case, for example, equity in a very high-growing business that if it really succeeds, could be very significant in terms of the value of Horizon.
Okay, Darrin, it sounds like you are going to be very busy in the next month ahead of us. But tell us, when we next speak to you, what is it likely to be about?
Well, so first of all, we're going to be announcing our full-year results in April, and then we'll start sort of effectively showing you just how well we did in FY14, in addition to our trading update. You'll see a continuing number of deals where we're driving the growth of our products business, where we're selling now 23,000 products to end-user customers, but also our products are now becoming part of other people's products in research and diagnostics. So effectively, we're getting value of other people's products as they're selling, so that scalable part of our products business. Services, very much, you know, about consistent, strong growth, high margin, and this research biotech piece, this is the first in an array of types of deals that you might see that will yield milestones, royalties, and potentially, you know, who knows, maybe more joint ventures or spin-outs.
Okay, thank you very much, Darrin.
Okay, thank you so much. Have a good morning.
And you, Darrin Disley, Chief Executive Officer at Horizon Discovery.